Hello YouTube. En hello to my dear subscribers. Another video from Karda. And today I'm quite excited to make a video. Because it's about my favorite games. Or game series that for me that is. And it is a top 7 of my favorite Tales of games. And basically I came to that idea of making this video this morning. I was watching a video on YouTube, basically a compilation video of all kinds of Tales games, and that brought back so many good memories about the Tales games that I could not withheld myself to make this video. I like talking about Tales of games, and in real life, nobody of my friends or people that I know play RPG games, so talking to them about Tales games, that doesn't make any sense. They barely know Final Fantasy, but that's it. But before we get to the good part of this video, I want to say two more things. The first thing is I wish you all, and especially my subscribers, I wish you all a happy new year. And a few people especially I wanted to make a shout out for, and that is, or a special new year, good new year, is for Paul with his guitar, Michael Monty, Atticus MGA of course, and I already start forgetting a lot of names. Yeah, all people that usually comment to my videos, I really appreciate it very much. I'm not very into social media, but the way YouTube does is that's lots of fun. We have a good gathering of people which love to talk about RPG games, and that always makes me happy to talk about it or watch your videos. Sejal, of course, you as well, happy new year. And the last one is, I cannot forget of course, is Whisper Ocean. I also wish her a happy new year. And for your cat as well, of course, Lucky is looks like a very sweet cat. So that's part one. Everybody, happy new year, and all the best to you. And the second part is about two shelves. Yesterday I bought two shelves to fix on my wall. Basically all the time all my games were in some kind of box, so they were inside a box, and now I have two shelves in which I almost was able to stack all my games. And I'll give a quick tour. It's just a few seconds. In the bottom shelf we have from here to here, this part are PlayStation Portable games. Then this is the Vita games. Here is a little stack of more PlayStation Portable games. Then over here are the Nintendo Wii games. And then on top we have one PlayStation 3 title here. Then this part is Nintendo 3DS until here, and let me slide the camera a bit. And this is Ys Salsetta. Then we get the PlayStation 3 titles, Xbox 360, and a few more PlayStation 3 titles that are in a box. So I'm very happy I'm happy with these shelves. They look very. I like it to just look at them this way now very much. So I'm very happy with the shelves, and now that I have them on display in my room. So that's the first two things I wanted to say, and let's get to the main part. My favorite series, Tales of games. And before I start with my favorite 7, I want to talk about two games that I did not want to include in this game. Basically because I was disappointed about these two Tails games. Or I did not like them very much. And the first one that did not get in my top, that I didn't make a top 9, but I decided to make a top 7 without these two games. And the first one is Tales of Mythology, Tales of the World, for the PlayStation Portable. It doesn't feel like a Tales game. The dungeons are randomly created, like Persona 3 and Persona 4, that style. And there's not much story, just... No, I did not like that game very much. And another one that I absolutely do not want to have in my list, and maybe that will surprise some of you. The other one I don't want in my list is Tales of Celia. Here in Europe, the latest release of a Tales game. And I had a lot of problems with that game. Basically, I don't like the characters. I feel there's not much depth in their story. The battle system was okay-ish. But the surroundings and the areas, it's to my opinion a rushed game. There's no alchemy in the game, no item gathering to upgrade your weapons. They removed a lot of stuff. And all by all, I didn't feel it was a Tales game that we were used to. And the only character I liked in Celia was of course this one, Tipo. That guy. If I wanted to buy a doll, it would be Tipo. He was kinda nice monster or nice doll, whatever. So I decided not to include those two games. And my favorite top 7. At number 7, I do not own that game. Is Tales of Phantasia. That had been released for the PlayStation 1 and the... One of the Sega systems. Or Nintendo, an old Nintendo. Basically that was... the first Tales of game that I ever played. And I think I played not the PlayStation 1 version, but the fan-translated version on the Super Nintendo, maybe it was. And that was basically the first Tales game that I ever played. And maybe one of the first RPG games as well. There's not much I remember about Phantasia, but what I remember is... The beginning of the game, when you start in that town and you have to hunt for a boar in the south in the forest. That part I can clearly remember. And at those days I didn't know what grinding was. So when I entered the forest I can clearly remember killing enemies and leveling up, getting stronger. And I was like, hey! If I'll stay in this forest and kill lots of monsters, I will be very strong. So I was very happy with the conclusion that, hey, I can get stronger if I stay here and hunt some more monsters. And like I said, I didn't know what grinding was. I also remember that first boar, that was really a tough boss. And that kwam very soon in the game. Then I remember that tree where you went up to. A big tree, and you had to go inside, and a dungeon in that open tree. I remember clearly. So at number 7 is Tales of Phantasia, which basically introduced me to what RPG games are all about. Then at number 6, a Tales of game that I enjoyed very very much. And if you love the PlayStation Portable and If you love Tales games, this one, you cannot afford not have playing this one. And that's for Europe, Tales of Eternia. And for the USA, Tales of Destiny 2. I think, but I think I'm correct. Like I said, if you like the PlayStation Portable and Tales, this is really a good one. I like the story very much about that singing girl. And yeah, I have good memories about Tales of Eternia. Much better than Tales of the World. That yeah, so Tales of Eternia at number 6. Very recommendable. And I think at this moment it will not be very expensive to buy that one if you have not bought it already. Now we are getting to the really good ones, top 5. And at number 5, it's the Wii Tales of game for the Nintendo Wii. And that is Tales of Symphonia. I'm looking at the cover right now. It's Tales of Symphonia, Dawn of the New World. Basically the sequel to the GameCube, Tales of Symphonia. You get all the characters from the GameCube, Tales of Symphonia. But this is with a different protagonist and that girl with long hair. And that girl got a dog, but don't call him a dog, Ratatosk. I remember his name. And the protagonist is Emil. You see them both, Emil and that girl. And some people did not like this game very much. They hated the protagonist, Emil. But I liked it very much. He starts as a very shy boy. And due to his adventures and that girl, his character changes from a boy to a man. And very, very, very good Wii game. Like I said, you get to meet all the Tales of Symphonia, yeah, GameCube characters, Colette and Genis. I've forgotten so many names. But this is really, really, I enjoyed this Wii game so very much. At number 4 is the Xbox 360 Tales of game. And that is Tales of Vesperia. And I started appreciating Tales of Vesperia more after I played Xillia, which I was so disappointed at. So after playing Xillia, I went straightly back to Tales of Vesperia to give it another try. And that's the moment that I really got in love with this Tales games. That small guy with the big hammer is very laughable. Yeah, I like Tales of Vesperia very much. It was greatly designed. I remember that town with the big tree, with the pink leaves. That's something I will never forget. That town looked so good. And it got the alchemy system, it's got everything you want. You grind for items to upgrade your weapons. The protagonist, how was he called? This guy. I did not get a bonding with him very much, like other Tales games. But yeah, it's a great Tales game. Highly recommendable. At number 3, I do not have the physical copy. At this moment it's very expensive to buy it. And that is Tales of Symphonia for the GameCube. And all and each character in Tales of Symphonia for the GameCube. So good story. And especially I like that little girl with the big axe. That's she was one of the strongest fighters in the game. And the guy with his chains. Tales of Symphonia is my number 3 favorite Tales game. Another good thing is in Tales of Symphonia you rebuild the world. And that's also the good part of playing the Wii version. It's the same world as the GameCube version, but then you will see it in higher resolution and new. The world is built up due to your work in the GameCube version. So I like that series very much, and I'm very happy it will be released next year for the PlayStation 3. So I can play Symphonia 1 again for sure. That's my favorite of the two. And then of course continue again with Symphonia 2, Dawn of the New World with Emil. At number 2 is the other PlayStation 3 Tales of game, which is my second best favorite Tales game. And that is Tales of Graces F. Whisper Ocean, if you have a PlayStation 3, I do not remember if you have it, I think you own one. Give this game a try. It's no bloody game. It's 12 years and older, so it will not. You will not have problems with this game. The story in this game is one of my best, one of my favorite stories ever. Three friends from the youth, and they grow up, and they meet again, and really awesome. It's got the alchemy system, weapon upgrade system. The areas look marvelous, really marvelous. There has been spent a lot of time in Tales of Graces F to make it sound good, look good. The battle system is my second favorite battle system from all the Tales games. I like the part where you can rush behind an enemy and stab him from the back. Really, this is such the characters as well. One of my, it's my number 2 favorite Tales game. Highly, highly recommendable. If you haven't played a Tales game, try Tales of Graces F. Don't start with Celia, please. I assure you, you will not be disappointed. Yeah, my favorite number 1 Tales game. And I'll show it first. It's a shame I only have the 3DS version. It's Tales of the Abyss. The PlayStation 2 title never came to Europe, and I still have not forgiven Namco for making that decision. Not bringing Tales of the Abyss to Europe on the PlayStation 2 is I can still not comprehend. But we got the 3DS version, but if I'm gonna play this game, it surely will not be on the 3DS. I'll play it again on my PlayStation 2 emulator on the PC, on the big screen. That's where Tales of the Abyss belongs, PlayStation 2. And oh my god, did I like the story and the characters. How was that red guy called? Was that Luke? Luke van Fabre? I think, Luke. He starts the game as a bigger asshole. Incredibly naive, not naive, but oh my god. He was such a dick in the start of the game. And then he meets Tyr. And with Tyr and other characters as well, of course. He ventures to the world and he becomes such a different guy. It's my favorite story. And all the characters that are able to be in your party have so much depth. I like Tyr very much. I still do. One of my favorite GRPG female characters. She's great. And the battle system as well is my number one favorite battle system. And especially the part where you can, your magic caster can cast a glyph on the ground. Let's say if you encounter a fire enemy, and first you'll let your spellcaster cast a water glyph on the ground, and then with your sword you'll do a water skill on top of it, you'll get a massive damage. And so I like that very much. I still have not forgotten that part of the game. I surely would hoped for a PlayStation 3 remake of this game, but now they have released it on the 3DS, that's probably not coming. So I'm sure gonna replay this game one of these days on the PlayStation 2. It's for me the best Tales of game that I ever played. And that's basically all. Tales of Destiny, there are a few that I never played. Tales of Destiny for the PlayStation 2. And probably there's also a Tales game for the Nintendo Dual Screen, which had only been released in Japan, but there's also a fan translated version for the DS of that Tales game. I don't know the title right now, but the Destiny 1 for the PlayStation 2 and that DS title I wasn't very interested in anyway. So that's all, Tales of the Abyss. And yeah, two of my favorite series are Tales games and SMT games. And it's which one I like more, SMT or Tales, is a very hard decision, but both of them are very enjoyable. And I'm more into turn-based battle system, but how Tales does the battle system is for me is very good doable. So that's a good plus, and I like that battle kind of system as well, especially for in the Tales games. That's all I wanted to say. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you like Tales games as well. And again, to everybody who's watching this, Happy New Year. And of course, we'll see each other again in 2014. Bye bye from Karna.